City of Switzerland with another real review, because in the last couple of weeks you have only seen unboxings and Borrowed Blades episodes, but now I got a little bit of time at hand to do some real reviews again. And today we're gonna take a look at a new knife from CRKT for 2020. I got a bunch of them pretty recently and had some time to play with them. And there are a couple of these knives that really impressed me. First off, the knives that we look at today, and that is this one here, the CRKT Inara from one of my favorite overall designers, which is Richard Rogers. And this is a very nice, smallish, sleek, slender EDC blade. And you know that is pretty much where I like to be with my knives. That really is in my wheelhouse. And the Inara here is certainly up to that task, in my opinion. So you see a pretty standard overall construction from CRKT. We have some real G10 scales here. Black G10, good traction, not overly strong, but still provides a good amount of grip. Of course, on a knife like this, I would love to see something a little bit dressier, maybe some kind of carbon fiber or something else that looks a little bit more high-end. But you know, this is a pretty affordable knife. The prices of the Inara is just under $40 at $39.99 in most places. What you get as well is, of course, a stainless steel frame lock at this price point. It's normally going to be stainless steel. You won't find any titanium frame lock knives at this price point in general. We have also this very well done black wash finish on the blade as well as on the stainless steel frame lock. Also here, for a sleek, slender, stylish EDC kind of knife, I would like to see a stonewashed or satin finish blade and a more silvery finish on the stainless steel. But as it is done here, everything ties well together, and I just would love to see a different kind of version of the Inara with a little bit of dressed up kind of style, where maybe you have a carbon fiber scale, a stonewashed stainless steel frame lock, and a satin finished blade. That would certainly look quite good. But as is right here, this knife really impressed me. I saw it when they released their new models, and this was not the first knife that I said I really need to have this. But over time, it grew on me, and I decided to get one, and I'm very, very happy that I did. So first off, let's take a look at the specs of this knife. So as I said before, G10 handle scale, stainless steel frame lock, running on captured IKBS bearings. We have the logo right here. So these are actually captured bearings in a white kind of polymer ring. And we have a HCR14 MOV stainless steel blade with a slight hollow grind and this very gorgeous Warncliffe blade shape. Overall length on the CRKT Inara is 6.63 inches or 16.8 centimeters with a blade length of 2.8 inches or 7 centimeters. And we have a very nice thin and slicey blade stock here, where with just 2.26 millimeters, so very nice and thin. You also can see that you get a very good delicate tip, which is great for piercing tasks and certainly suits the size and the roll of this knife very well. I wouldn't like if it had a very stout kind of blade stock on an application and a design like this, which certainly comes across as a great little gentleman's EDC carry piece. Then we have a hand length of 3.8 inches or 9.8 centimeters, which for my hand is a really good size. You know, I have a small to medium hand, 7.5 sterile glove, and it fits my hand really well. We have a pretty neutral kind of handle, so not a lot of finger choice, just a nice cutout to get very easily to your lock bar there. But other than that, pretty straight handle, slight curvature here on the back, and certainly fits the hand quite well, even though it is certainly not a broad knife, so you don't have a big handle to grab onto. It's also rather thin overall. We have a polymer backspacer with some texturing here in the back that is finished flush, so nothing sticking up and interrupting the lines, which is also done very nice. Here they could do something very interesting to add a little bit of color or a little bit more sophistication to the mix when they would put in something made out of brass or some other kind of interesting material instead of a black polymer backspacer, but that is certainly also a question of price point. But overall size is very nice for me. It tucks away beautifully. It's also actually quite lightweight. We have an overall weight here with the stainless steel lock bar or a lock side here, which is not actually skeletonized, of just 1.8 ounces for the blade length of almost 3 inches. And that is certainly a great weight, and you certainly do not notice when you're carrying this knife. Also coupled with the very slender and thin overall form factor, this tucks away greatly, and you still get a very usable overall cutting edge here with the Inara. So that is certainly one of the biggest benefits, together with the very good looking overall design by Richard Rogers. You see a very interesting and unique design feature are these two continuous lines that continue from the blade into the handle. Things like that I really like, when they have a design element that really combines the blade and the handle. I like these millings in the blade. In use, for me, they haven't caused any kind of problems with material sticking on there. They're very easy to wipe out because they have a continuous line that reaches the other end, so you can just wipe it out like this and it is absolutely no problem. And we have it also on both sides. It's also something that I really appreciate, when you have design elements that are mirrored on both sides of the knife, even though we have here the stainless steel and here the G10. So overall, very nicely done on the design and the form factor for the knife that it wants to be. Now, action on the Inara is also a strong suit of this knife. I said before, this runs on captured IKBS bearings in a polymer racing, and you certainly notice that. It has a very nice and strong detent and a pretty much free-falling action. And for that kind of money that you're spending here on the Inara, I think that is a pretty nice achievement that CRKT has been able to attain here. So very well done on the action, nice and strong thumb flicker. You can also do it slowly and controlled when you want to not scare anybody. That works also quite well. But of course, the thumb stud, as you have seen before, is only one-sided, so this will be not good for a lefty knife, also because your pocket clip is not going to be switchable to the other side. So only tip up right side carry with this kind of clip right here. Normally, you see me complain about clips that are not deep carry, but with the knife being that slender and slim, and it's been very easy to extract out of the pocket with these two screws here, and the clip is rather understated also with that black wash finish that goes very well with darker pants. I think this clip actually suits the knife very well. It goes very nice and easy into the pocket and getting out of there, because it lands on this stainless steel frame lock. So overall, pretty well done on the clip. For this design, it works great also because you don't have a lot of material that takes up a lot of space in your pocket. So very easy to keep your wallet or anything together with the knife in your pocket. So that is certainly a great thing about this knife. You can also use it in a spider flick when you have it in your left hand. That's also because we have a very good detent on the Inara here. That was something that was quite surprising to me when I got the knife. First, I didn't expect the action to be as good as it is. You can also open it two-handed if you would like to do that, because we have these nice milled lines in the blade, so very easy to just open it like that. I could also see CRKT coming out with a German legal version of this, where they just would remove the thumb stud, and then you would have a nice two-handed locking knife that would be legal to carry pretty much anywhere in Germany and probably also in the UK. So that could be a great idea for a two-handed version of the Inara. Lockup here is also done perfectly well. Here you can see the lockup of the stainless steel frame lock. We have absolutely no play in any direction, rock solid lockup, and just the overall knife feels built up very well, especially for the price point that we are at here. Of course, the steel that they're using is nothing that's going to blow anybody out of the water, but it's a good serviceable steel that's easy to maintain and sharpen for pretty much anybody. And that's probably the reason why they picked the steel. And I can see that certainly, but as I said in a bunch of my CRKT videos, I would love to see a steel upgrade across the board, where they would go to some kind of a Sandvik steel or something along those lines, just to give their knives more value, because they, in my opinion, have in the budget knife realm the best design collaborations that are out there, and they have so much great designers. You will see knife reviews of the new knives, just the new knives of some really hallmark designers like Jesper Voxnes, Brian Tai, Richard Rogers, and Eric Ox. And I have a bunch of older CRKT reviews where you see Ken Onion and a bunch of other very great designers that work with CRKT and bring us some really iconic designs for an everyday guy with an everyday budget. And that is what I really like about CRKT, because they usually do quite a good job executing these designs. Just the materials sometimes leave you hanging a little bit when you're lusting for something a little bit more premium. I think also this Inara model would be very well suited to a higher end Italian made kind of version of a CRKT. You know, CRKT has released a couple of higher end models, but they normally were pretty large ones, and also models that haven't been released so far. So if they would establish a higher end kind of version or line of their knives, I think the Inara could be a great entry with a titanium frame lock, maybe something along the lines of S30B on the steel, nice hand rub satin finish, and something interesting for the main scale, maybe a wood or something. That would look absolutely gorgeous and would really suit this knife, in my opinion. One thing I noticed over use and carry of the Inara is that you really have to know how to manipulate and use a slender knife like this, because on a couple of reviews that I have done, I got some comments that they were saying it's very hard to open these slender knives, I don't know what I'm doing wrong, and normally it's just that people press on the lock bar and then it pretty much becomes impossible to open the knife, or almost impossible, because you're pressing the detent pole inside the hole in the blade where the detent is created. But on these more slender knives, it is a little bit more difficult to put your hands elsewhere, because you see, you don't have a lot of real estate on that quite slender handle. But for me, I have pretty much, I'm pretty much used to manipulating slender knives like this, because I have quite a bunch of them. And for me, it hasn't been any issue whatsoever, but it is certainly something that you have to keep in mind, especially if you have larger hands. It could be a little bit of an issue to put your fingers not on that lock bar, but for me, that hasn't been an issue whatsoever. So overall, I'm very, very impressed with the overall package here of the Inara by CRKT and Richard Rogers. And now let's take a look at some size comparison that we like to do here on the channel. First off, we have always the Chirogorov sandwich. Even though we have quite a big price difference between these knives, I think they provide a good size reference if you handled an F95NL or a Chirogorov Neon, or have seen them. So you see, it's quite a bit smaller than both of these knives. It's really a great compact EDC gentleman style folder here from CRKT. And then we have our benchmark EDC blades. We have a Paramilitary 3 or Para 3 with sharp dress knives, aftermarket scales, and my bug out here with Alan Putman aftermarket grooved micarta scales. And you can see it is even smaller than both of those. Cutting edge wise, it's a little bit longer than a Para 3, but of course ergonomics, when you do some harder work, the Spyderco here is better. Then we have some other knives that I think are pretty good comparisons in overall size. We have, for example, here the Quiet Carry IQ, one of my favorite office carry type knives. Great action, certainly more expensive than the Inara, but size-wise, you can see these two are very, very close in the overall profile. You got a little bit different blade shape, and of course, quite a bit different materials. Both run on bearings, both have a very, very good action, especially for these light blades. It's hard to achieve this kind of a free-falling action. And here you can see them close side to side. So the Inara is a little bit broader in the pocket. But overall, these two knives are actually quite similar also in thickness and blade stock. So if you have an IQ, you certainly can see what the size of the Inara is. And then I have two other knives. Here we have the Benchmade Sequel, which is unfortunately discontinued, but in length pretty close to the Inara as well. And then I have an older CRKT that still is in my collection because it's just that gorgeous and has also a very great action here from IKBS bearings, is the CRKT Ripple. And you can see it's smaller than the Ripple in every dimension and about the same in length on the Benchmade Sequel. And the last comparison that I have is another absolutely gorgeous but quite a bit more expensive EDC Gentleman's Folder from Chris Reeve. This is a Nundi in spalted beechwood scales, also a thing that has been in my collection for a longer kind of time. And I think these two are size-wise also not that far apart. Also in terms of uses, I certainly would pick the Inara to be a little bit more leaning towards full use EDC blade. If you have a lighter use EDC, then the Nundi is quite of a dress-up knife, but also a gentleman's carry. So I think these two go pretty well together as well. So I hope you get a feel for the size of the CRKT Inara. I'm really impressed with what they could achieve here. Of course, there are always these little things that you have to sacrifice a little bit regarding price. It was quite sharp out of the box, but they missed the plunge grind a little bit. We have quite a thickening up of the edge just here at the back, but I love that they went with a nice slight hollow grind so they could achieve quite a thin edge here, a thin grind behind the edge there, also using the hollow grind that was done quite well. But of course the final sharpening chunk could have been done better. We have all the markings on the CRKT blades that I always like to be toned down a little bit. I can live with the Rogers design logo. I would prefer the Rogers logo somewhere. The IKBS is fine and the name, but all tucked away and a little bit slimmer. Don't need the serial number, and the CRKT logo could be done a little bit more understated as well. But these are all quite small nitpicks. Overall, I can highly recommend the CRKT Inara if you're looking for an inexpensive, slender EDC blade that it can carry everywhere and that will not be bulky or cumbersome to carry, but still you have a quite useful cutting edge on your person and a very fun fidgeting knife with a great action. And that all for under $40. I think CRKT has produced another home run knife, and I'm very happy that I have my Inara here on the table and in my collection. And I would really love to see a higher end version or a more dressy kind of finished version of the Inara in the future, and I hope this model will be here to stay for a longer time. So let me know what you think about the review, if you have an Inara and how you like it. And please follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knives_reviews. And if you like my content, please consider supporting me via Patreon. You will see a link to my Patreon page in the description as well as in the top right corner right there. And if you want to buy some new knives, for example, a CRKT Inara, please check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount 7ready to get 10% off every order. So thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.